Don't get married next summer. Don't go to a courthouse. Don't go to Vegas. You'll probably drop out of school.
Hey alligators, what's up? It's Allie Hardesty. In today's video, I am so excited to be filming. It is currently the end of December and I am going to be doing a reaction to my predictions for 2018 from a professional astrologer. This is gonna be a lot of fun because one, you guys get to live react with me to see what the future possibly has in store, but also because I'm gonna give you guys a special deal. Well, technically she's gonna give you guys a special deal on a reading if you wanna go ahead and get one yourself after watching this video and you see what it's like and if you're interested. I have had a lot of people ask me since I've mentioned her in videos how they could get one themselves, and I feel like a lot of people would love to try something like this out themselves, whether it's like a natal chart or doing a composite reading where they're comparing their chart with like their significant others or just predictions for the following year. But the problem is there are a lot of people who aren't so legitimate out there. As you guys know, I've had a couple encounters with like psychics that are basically low-key scam artists, so you just never know sometimes. And I can honestly say that I would never steer you guys wrong with this person. She has done my reading for me more than once and she has told me things about myself that I've literally never told anybody, and there's like no other possible way she would be able to know other than she actually does this for a living and she's a real astrologer. If you guys want to check that out, I will have the information listed below in the description box. But basically, if you go ahead and email her with the subject line saying Allie, you can get a reading for 30 minutes for $20 or 45 minutes for $40 or for an hour for $60, which is a really, really good freaking deal because usually they're a lot more expensive than that. But the requirements in order to get your reading done is she only accepts PayPal and you must give her your birth time in order to get an accurate reading, and these sessions are done via phone or if you would prefer Skype. Astrology is just a lot of fun, and if you're someone who doesn't believe in it, you probably don't fully understand it. This is not the thing that you see in the newspaper where it says you're gonna have a good day today because you're a Leo. This is real astrology where there are a lot of different aspects that affect you in a lot of different ways. And I just want to say, when I do get into this video, I will be calling her live and like holding it where you guys can hear, but she is going to do a more in-depth reading for me off camera because this stuff does get pretty personal. Plus, we would be sitting here for like an hour and that would be crazy to edit and my camera would die. So yeah, without further ado, let's just give her a call.
So Allie, this is your year in preview for 2018. Looks like some big stuff is happening. You make some money.
This year I'm going to?
Yeah, but be careful with it. Don't invest in Bitcoin or anything. You're going to start off the year with a lot of energy. You've got Mars on your sun. You are really going to be exploring new things, big changes. And I don't know if you were planning on just having like a quiet little move. I know you said you wanted to kind of redecorate, like adult your apartment. I don't know if you're going to have the time for that. I think that you're going to be meeting a lot of people, and I think you're kind of going to get thrown into situations relatively quickly. You're going to be having a lot of fun. I think you're going to find that you have a lot of freedom. You're going to enjoy it. You're going to make some life changes because of it.
Good or bad life changes?
Probably good, because it's Jupiter and Jupiter brings good things, and it's mental. It's on Mercury and your sun. You're almost going to have like a whole new way of thinking about things.
Ooh, I like that.
It'd be a good time to write, plan your blogs ahead of time, kind of keep doing what you're doing, but up the ante a little bit. I think you're going to touch more lives, and I think you're going to make more people happy, and I think that your popularity is going to grow, and I think because of that, that'll bring more money in. So keep working. Okay, so you've got transiting Venus coming up on your natal Jupiter in the seventh house of marriage and partnership, so you will be probably meeting somebody.
Do you know what kind of sign they are?
Not yet. I have to look for that. We'll check ahead in 2 months when the transit happens. But remember, you and I had discussed about you having Saturn in the seventh house, how Saturn represents like an older man.
Yeah.
A more mature man. Maybe Capricorn. A Capricorn would be good for you. Pluto is also in Capricorn as well, which has that regenerative factor, and it'll be there for about 2.5 more years. So I could see you getting into a long-term relationship with this person.
Makes me nervous.
It's a possibility for you. If you want that option, it could manifest. You'll be going to this new school and you have Neptune in your ninth house of education. So you'll be doing creative things. I think you're going to be distracted by the other stuff that's going on in your life. So you may not be taking school as seriously as you should.
I don't know like how on track exactly I am, but I just got my associate. So I essentially had 2 more years worth, but I think I'm going to take it really slow. So it's going to be like 2.5 years.
Yeah, it's probably a good idea because you've got things to do. Remember we talked about Chiron, which is that karmic stone that you serve or you suffer, and it's in your 10th house of work. So you'll probably be working really hard to grow a brand, to grow your business. Have you thought about doing like alligator t-shirts?
I wanted to. I actually like talked to somebody who's a designer and they sketched some stuff up for me, but I've been waiting to try to work with Amazon because they have like a waiting list and they just came out with like Amazon merch.
But that's a 2-year waiting list. You need to go somewhere else. I think by the time Amazon rolls around, you'll be over it and you'll be on to the next thing. So you've got transiting Uranus retrograding in your 11th house of friendships. And this is where I'm going to warn you about picking the wrong people to share your private business with. Uranus brings chaos. Uranus brings things that are unexpected. You might make a great best friend. You might make a great best friend through the internet. Uranus is electronics. It's a good time to do collaborations with other people. It's not just assholes. But the potential for assholes exists. You need to be more cognizant before you open your arms to everybody. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It looks like you've got Mercury in Sagittarius in your 6th house of daily tasks. You're going to be working. I think Patreon will probably bring you more money than you think. And doing more things like getting that merchandise out there and sponsoring stuff. You might want to get more into that as well. Just working your ass off. Oh, you have all this stuff going on in your 9th house and your 10th house. You'll probably drop out of school.
Really?
Yeah.
When?
Spring.
So you think after spring I'm not going to continue?
I think you might take your break then. You got too much going on, career-wise.
Do you think I'll go back to it later?
You don't need to, but you need that piece of paper.
Do you think I'll force myself to finish?
Well, you know, being a Scorpio, you don't have to force yourself to do anything. Once you decide to do something, it's kind of a done deal. I think you'll just find that you're so busy that you kind of have to stop for a while and get all this other shit into gear. Once you've got that as like a going machine, you'll be able to return to school and let everything else be passive income and you be on a schedule, and then it'll be less on your mind. Especially if you're meeting somebody else as well, you're going to be all giggity about that. You may or may not have unfinished business with Virgos. So that's something to contend with, however you decide to do that. Is your intuition telling you that this is correct or incorrect?
Correct.
I think when Neptune leaves the 9th house of education, you'll go back to school. Okay. But as long as it's there, it's not a priority. Saturn's getting real close to your 7th house. That's Capricorn. And you have Venus in your 12th at that time, so it'll be someone that you know from a past life.
Oh, the guy?
Yeah, and you're still making money. So it's the first 5 months of the year, and you're bringing in money. Pluto and Mars conjunct Neptune in your 7th house. So if you have any unfinished business, that ought to take care of it. You know what I mean?
Yeah, and that's when, like May, you said?
Mm-hmm. It'll suck, but that'll be the end of that. Pluto's regenerative. You never know. He may keep his word and do what he says that he's going to do, but it may be too late. You might be with somebody else. I think that dead horse is going to get beat a lot, despite your attempts to avoid it. But I think come May, you'll have had enough. You'll see the true Scorpio, what a Scorpio can do. This is usually destroy anything in their path. July, you're out of school, correct?
Yeah.
Working, skipping school, seriously making money, communicating. You don't write at all.
I do like to like journal, and I have wrote like lyrics and stuff to songs. I could see myself like possibly dabbling in that a little bit.
Yeah, dabble. Do some dabbling. I think you'll be happy with the outcome. That would also be a good time to start therapy if you have time. We are in September, so allegedly you're back in school. There's another person coming in September. A Libra?
Ooh.
Something new for you?
Yeah, I've never dated a Libra. You're talking about romantically, right?
Yeah, or that Capricorn still might be hanging around. Or it may not be a Capricorn, it just might be an older dude. Not that you have time for this shit. Jesus. I think you've got a theme this year. I think your theme is kind of like make your mark and see what else is out there romantically other than the pitfalls that you've tripped into. It's time to get out of that. Meet new people and explore new things, and if it doesn't look like it's for you, then you should try it. And you should branch out creatively any way that you feel that is necessary. And your parents just might have to deal with the fact that school's not in the cards at this time. You can finish it, but you're not going to finish it with Neptune in the 9th house. You're just not. When it gets in the 10th house, you might have people doing stuff for you, so you won't have to do as much and you can focus on school at that time.
That makes sense.
All right, it's your birthday month. More money. Mars is entering your 9th house. You'll probably go back for winter.
Oh, go back for school?
Yeah.
So you think during the summer I'm just not going to take any summer classes?
I think spring and summer you're going to be focused on other things. I know you said that you're not going to be doing what you're doing forever, but that doesn't mean that you can't show other people how to do it. And that doesn't mean that you can't write a book about it or a podcast or make a living off of what you've already done. You have skills, you have talents, and you have opportunities, and you have knowledge, most of all. And you can take all that and use that to your advantage and make money with it. So you may find that you're still working for yourself after graduation.
I hope so.
I mean, Pisces is the ruler of your 10th house of work. Pisces, of course, is a fish. You will swim to the top. You don't really want to be told what to do, especially being a Scorpio. You have a Virgo moon. You're already in tune of like how things need to be done intrinsically. You know more than the average bear just from life experience. People are going to be working for you at a young age. It's almost a shame you have to waste 2 years in school. You may decide that it's not for you. Mercury is on Pluto and so is Jupiter in your 5th house. You'll come up with more innovative ideas for your videos. You'll be teaching. You can charge people for that. And you need to...
Towards the end of the year or at what point?
I think you'll know. You and I can talk privately about...
Okay.
All right, let's do December. And then maybe we'll take a pop at January 2019. Just for shits and giggles. The node has moved out of your 2nd house of money and into your 1st house of who you are. So you'll be doing a lot of reflecting about the past year and the decisions that you've made. And are they the right ones for you? You still have Uranus retrograding in your 11th house. So it's been a year of experiences with people. And hopefully you have learned to make the right choices. Venus has moved off Chiron in the 5th. So that relationship is over. But... Saturn is out of the 7th as well. You are taking a break from men. Doesn't mean that you left the guy. It might be more like you've settled into a routine. And I think it's going to be one of those relationships, you know, how there's always one person that's more into the other.
Yeah.
You're going to be doing less work. It's a good year for you. Making bank. You're going to be doing what you want to do. You're probably going to have a hot dude. He's got some money of his own. The only problem is... residual that you left behind.
What do you mean residual?
Like an old issue.
Oh, with men?
Mm-hmm. Virgos. I mean, you're going to be having fun doing what you're doing. And I'm saying that the teaching thing is going to happen because there's so many Jupiter aspects. You may be getting requests to do what you do. You may find like you're a consultant of some sort and you should charge for that.
You know, it's funny you say that because I was actually telling my mom the other day that I've always wanted to put out a book or some type of program. I don't even really know what direction I would want to put it in, but I know that I do want to put out something that could help people and people could learn from.
You could easily write an ebook and self-publish it.
I've always wanted to do that.
Do it. There's absolutely nothing stopping you. It's the year of Allie. So you said that's what you wanted. It's happening. If you take advantage of the energy the way it's being presented to you, because there's free will, you have that option too, but that's not you. Let's just go into January the year after, and then we'll call it a chart. On New Year's Day, the moon is on your Mercury. It's a good sign. And the older Capricorn dude is back. You're still teaching. You're still learning about yourself. Neptune's still in the 9th house, so you're on school again. Mars is on Saturn with Chiron, so there's energy with work. Venus is in Scorpio, so whatever you're doing is intense. Don't get, like, married next summer.
Okay.
Yeah, don't do that. That might cross your mind. Don't go to a courthouse. Don't go to Vegas. Don't go through a drive-thru wedding, no matter how big the ring is. Don't move in with anybody. Other than that, I think you're in pretty decent shape.
I like it.
Bye, Allie viewers. Bye.
So, you guys heard it here first. That was my year prediction for 2018 and then the first month of 2019 even. So, Victoria is so awesome. I'm going to call her back in a few minutes here after I end out this video so we can talk more personally about a lot of the stuff that she mentioned. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. I thought that was so much fun. If you guys want to get a reading for yourself, I will have all that information, again, linked below in the description. Make sure you send her an email to that email linked below with the subject line as Allie, and then you can get the special rate that she's going to give you guys if you are in fact an alligator. And you don't just have to get your yearly predictions done. You can get it where it's your natal chart and she can tell you about yourself as a person. That was the first reading that I actually did with her and it taught me a lot of stuff. And you also can compare your chart with other people's, like your significant other or your mom, etc., which helps you understand other people a lot better and the way you interact with them. Just make sure you know your birthday. So again, check that about in the description box. I know you guys will love her as much as I do. She's so great. Let me know in the comment section below if you would be interested in me doing another one of these sometime in the future. It doesn't have to be a prediction, so to speak. Make sure you thumbs this video up. Subscribe if you are new here. Turn on post notifications by hitting that bell twice right next to the subscription box. Follow my social media. I also do have a Patreon if you guys want to check that out for exclusive photo shoots, private Snapchat, and unseen videos, etc. That will be linked below in the description box. And I will see you guys in the next video. Later, alligators. Bye.